In today's video, I'll be showing you how I color grade SLOG3 footage that has been shot during sunset. I'll show you a short sequence from a short documentary I shot about football culture in New York, and I was filming a scene with the guys from Secret FC, and I followed a member of the group, Abdul, who was on his way to McCarran Park to play ball with everybody from Secret Football Club. Let's watch the scene so you have a better understanding on how color grading can help your storytelling.
Secret Football Club is nothing more than a community, kind of this free-flowing group of people who just organize to play soccer. Now that you got me started, I just can't stop. No. What I think is cool about Secret Football Club is how organically, just through this shared passion for playing soccer, we've connected with people, and in some ways this is how I've met some of my closest friends. I met Abdul, who works at Brooklyn Grange, which is a rooftop farm. And next thing I know, he's showing up to my house with a bag of fresh produce. And I thought that was amazing. And then there's people like Adam, who actually helped me get my apartment and lives downstairs from me. And Adam met Alberto, who's going to tattoo him with his first Secret Football Club tattoo later today.
So, color grading is a very powerful tool that can be used to communicate emotion in a video. By adjusting the colors in a shot, you can create specific moods or a feeling that can affect the audience's emotional response. For example, take warm colors like red, orange, and yellow. They can create a feeling of warmth, happiness, and excitement. The goal of the scene was to show the love and happiness they feel while playing football. And the way I color grade can help me communicate that feeling. So here's the shot that we will be working with today. As you can see, the colors are very flat and desaturated, and that's because it's SLOG3 footage. And that's designed to be color graded in post-production. So let's start grading the footage. I already have the clip on my timeline, and first I'm going to look for the frame that I want to grade. Once I've made a decision, I go up to panel and select color. Then I go to the creative tab and I'm going to import my conversion lot. For this tutorial, I choose the Arri 01, and there's a link where you can download the conversion lot for free. It's in the description of my previous color grading video. And I choose to import the lot at the creative tab, and that's because there's an intensity slider. I think a bit over 100 will work. Now that that's done, we will duplicate the lumetric color layer and reset its settings. Then it's time to adjust the curves. I think I want to bring a bit more contrast into the shot, so I create an S-curve. And I'm also going to make some adjustments on the basic corrections tab. It really depends on the look I'm trying to create, and in this case, I really want the oranges to pop out. So now that I'm done with the basic corrections, I move on to the color wheel and match tab, and I'm going to bring more orange into the highlights, midtones, and shadows. Then I duplicate the lumetric color effect layer one more time and I reset its settings. The last step is drawing a mask. I'm going to draw a rough mask on the right corner of the screen, make it very big, and then feather it out a bunch. Then I'm going to push the temperature more towards the orange, and that's it, we're done. Let's toggle on and off the layers one by one to see what kind of effect each step has on the image. Step one was the conversion lot, step two were the curves and the exposure, and step three, the masking. And that was it for today. Hopefully you learned something new watching me color grade. And remember, color grading is a creative process that can enhance the story and the message of your video. So don't be afraid to experiment and try new things. Sometimes pushing your color to the limit can create a unique and powerful look that sets your video apart. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.